Hi everyone, I will present our work Neural-Dual Contouring. I am Zhiqin from Simon Fraser University. This work was done in collaboration with Andrea, Tom, and my supervisor Richard. Our method, Neural-Dual Contouring, is a unified data-driven approach that learns to construct meshes from a variety of inputs, such as grids of sign distances, grids of binary voxels, grids of unsigned distances, point clouds without normals, and noisy point clouds from raw scan data. Our method generalizes to a broad range of shape types, such as CAD models with sharp edges, organic shapes, closes with open surfaces, scans of indoor scenes, and even the non-artable mobile strip. In this presentation, I will first briefly describe marching cubes, dual contouring, and their issues. Then I will introduce our method, Neural Dual Contouring, or NDC for short. Then some implementation details, followed by the experiments, results, limitation, and future work. Let us quickly review two classic isosurfacing algorithms, marching cubes and dual contouring. We start with a 2D example. Given an implicit field, marching cubes first samples a grid of points and their sign distances, and then computes approximate intersection points on grid edges from those sign distances. Finally, it refers to a lookup table to create the surface within each voxel. However, since the vertices are only created on grid edges, marching cubes is incapable of preserving sharp features. On the other hand, dual contouring takes as input the signs of the grid vertices, the intersection points on grid edges, and the gradients of those points. It then computes interior vertices by solving a quadratic error minimization problem, specified by the edge points and their gradients. Finally, for each edge with a sign change, it generates a face connecting adjacent cells. The tessellation algorithm of dual contouring is significantly simpler than that of marching cubes, and can naturally preserve sharp features. However, dual contouring assumes additional input in the form of gradients at the intersection points. Such additional input makes it a less favorable algorithm for isosurfacing when compared to marching cubes. Our data-driven approach does not have this drawback. In neural dual contouring, we employ a convolutional neural network trained on example 3D surface data to predict the grid of signs as well as the vertex locations. Then we simply apply the dual contouring meshing algorithm to create the output polygonal mesh. Therefore, our method enjoys the simplicity of dual contouring while taking exactly the same input as marching cubes. Furthermore, note that the meshing algorithm of dual contouring only needs to know whether the edges are intersected by the output surface or not. Whether the signs are positive or negative doesn't matter. Therefore, we also introduce a sign-agnostic version of our method, which we name unsigned neural dual contouring, or UNDC for short. We train our network to predict the intersection flag per edge, indicating whether the cell edge is intersected by the surface or not, without accounting for the signs at cell corners. The output mesh is created by generating one face for each predicted edge intersection. Since UNDC does not need to predict the signs of the grid vertices, it is able to take unsigned inputs, such as unsigned distances or point clouds without normals, and output polygonal meshes with open boundaries. And that's it. The idea of our method is quite simple, but it is very effective. Now I will go into some details such as data preparation and network architectures. To prepare the training data, we will need a set of meshes. For each mesh, we place it in a grid to compute signs, intersection points, and their normals. Then we basically apply dual contouring to obtain the ground truth output grids. The vertex signs are simply the vertex signs. The edge intersection flags are obtained by checking whether there are intersection points on those edges. And the vertex locations can be obtained by solving the quadratic error functions in dual contouring. However, the quadratic error functions in dual contouring are very sensitive to the normals of the intersection points. And since the training shapes are discretized polygonal meshes, the normals of the intersection points are not exactly accurate. Therefore, if we directly apply dual contouring, the output meshes usually have poorly positioned vertices on curved surfaces. This might seem problematic. After all, these meshes are our ground truth. but we can actually use them to train the networks and have clean output matches with the help of data augmentation. All we need to do is to make sure that for the same input, the noise of the vertex positions has a zero mean distribution. We achieve that by augmenting the training data. We are flipping and rotating the ground truth output grids and inverting the inside-outside signs. And we use the mean squared error loss to supervise the training, which makes the output noise to be the average noise in the training data. And that average is zero. Now, I will show you the network architectures. For regular grid inputs, we apply a simple 3D convolutional neural network. It will take a 3D grid as input, and it will output a 3D grid. For point cloud inputs, we first apply a customized PointNet++ to make sure each operation is local and using relative coordinates. Then we pull the point features into a grid and apply 3D convolutional networks. We train the networks with binary cost entropy loss for the sign or edge intersection predictions, and mean squared error loss for the interior vertex predictions. For UNDC, there is a post-processing step. Because UNDC can take unsigned inputs and can produce open surfaces, it could make mistakes and generate small holes in the output mesh. We use a simple post-processing step to close these holes. This step is performed directly on the output grid of intersection flags before converting the grids into the output meshes. Before going into the experiments and results, I think it is worthwhile to compare NDC with our prior work, Neural Marching Cubes, or NMC, because these two works are closely related. NMC is based on marching cubes. It is data-driven and able to preserve sharp features, similar to our method. But it can only take signed inputs, meaning that it cannot take unsigned distances or point clouds as input. Therefore, we will compare the signed version of our method with NMC. First, let's look at the output complexity and the match translation. NMC outputs 5 Boolean values and 51 float values for each cube, and it has 37 unique tessellation cases. This additional complexity compared to marching cubes is required for reconstructing sharp features. Ours produces 1 Boolean value and 3 float values, and we simply create at most 1 quad phase for each edge. So our method is much simpler than NMC. As a result, NMC has 8 times the number of vertices and triangles compared to marching cubes, and ours has approximately the same amount as marching cubes. Next, the implementation difficulty. As explained, NMC is much more complex than NDC, and its implementation is harder from data preparation to the meshing algorithm. Moreover, NMC requires a complex regularization loss when the input is ambiguous or noisy. Our method does not need a regularization loss. Next, training time and inference speed. NMC takes 4 days to train one network, and ours takes less than 12 hours. NMC takes more than a second to process each shape, and ours can process more than 30 shapes per second. There are other comparisons, which I will talk more about in the experiment section. In our experiments, we compare our method and various other methods on reconstructing meshes from grids of signed distances, grids of unsigned distances, grids of binary voxels, point clouds without normals, and real scans, which are dense, noisy point clouds without normals. We train our method on the training split of the ABC dataset, and test on ABC, CINK, FOST, MGN, and MathPort3D. In our first experiment, we reconstruct meshes from grids of signed distances. We compare our method, both the signed and the unsigned versions, with marching cube 33, dual countering with estimated normals, and two versions of neural marching cubes. We replace the 3D CNN networks in NMC with our networks used in NDC to have a fair comparison with respect to the inference time. Here are some visual results. Note the artifacts produced by NMC, and NDC produces cleaner surfaces. Also notice that none of the methods can reconstruct thin structures, except for UNDC. Here are quantitative results for 3 testing datasets with 2 different input resolutions. UNDC outperforms all other methods in reconstruction quality, as reflected by chamfer distance, F-score, and normal consistency. UNDC also outperforms other methods in sharp feature preservation as reflected by ECD and EF1, which are chamfer distance and F-score defined on sharp edges. NDC and UNDC produce similar amounts of vertices and triangles compared to classic door contouring and marching cubes, which are significantly fewer than those of NMC. Finally, the inference speed of NDC and UNDC is much faster than NMC, although they have the same backbone network. We also evaluated the quality of the output surfaces by plotting the percentage of inaccurate surface normals and the percentage of small acute angles in the output triangles. Notice that the blue curves representing our method are always the lowest, meaning that our method has better surface normals and better triangle quality. Here are some examples showing that our method has better triangle quality by producing less triangles with small acute angles. Here, we test the robustness of the methods by testing them on a shape while rotating the shape inside the sampling grid. It clearly shows that NDC is the most robust compared to others. In the next experiment, we reconstruct meshes from grids of unsigned distances. To the best of our knowledge, UNDC is the only method that can perform this task. Therefore, we do not compare with others. Our method can faithfully reconstruct open surfaces on these closes. Next, we reconstruct meshes from grids of binary voxels. Similar to the results in the previous experiments, NDC and UNDC outperform the other methods. Here are some visual results. Note the artifacts produced by NMC, and NDC produces cleaner surfaces. In the next experiment, we reconstruct meshes from point clouds. We compare our method, UNDC, with ball pivoting and screen Poisson, representing classic methods, and Siren, local implicit grids, and convolutional occupancy networks, representing deep learning methods. Here are the quantitative results. Note that these methods require point normals as input, except for convolutional occupancy networks and our method. Still, our method outperforms all others in terms of reconstruction quality and sharp feature preservation. We produce the second least number of vertices and triangles, and our method is the fastest. Here are some visual results. It is clear that our method performs the best. Here, the input point clouds have density variations within the same shape. We show the results of our method when the output grid size is 64 cubic or 128 cubic. Here, the input point clouds have noise variations within the same shape. In both density and noise variations, our method is more robust. Finally, in the last experiment, we reconstruct meshes from raw scan data and compare with screen Poisson. Notice how Poisson tends to produce noisy surfaces. Poisson may also trim the parts incorrectly and may not be able to reconstruct thin structures. Poisson can also generate bubble artifacts because of its water tightness prior. Here is another scene with more such artifacts. The most prominent limitation of our method is that it can produce non-manifold meshes. For NDC, it could generate non-manifold edges with four adjacent faces, as shown here. For UNDC, because it does not have the water tightness prior that NDC has, it could generate non-manifold edges with three or four adjacent faces, and boundary edges with one adjacent face. These non-manifold edges are useful when approximating the ground truth, but they may cause issues for downstream tasks. Another issue of our method is the edge artifacts. They cannot be easily fixed because they are caused by the inherent properties of neural networks. Neural networks map continuous inputs into continuous output values. However, consider when the sign distance of a vertex moves from 0 positive to 0 negative. The input changes in a continuous way, but the position of this output vertex has to change in a discrete way. And this contradicts the properties of neural networks. In the future, we want to explore the possibility to reconstruct meshes with guaranteed manifoldness, and combining NDC with neural radiance fields or differentiable renders to reconstruct possibly one-sided surfaces from multiple images. Thank you for watching.